Hello, hey, thanks for watching my video. It's Russell Peden here. I just wanted to, all I can say is, wow, man, I would have never imagined that my little interview with Breitbart News at the Blexit Rally in Richmond, Virginia, hosted by Candace Owens, would resonate with so many people all over the world. Nearly a million people have watched that interview. Over 40,000 people have liked it. Over 30,000 people have shared it with their friends and family. And thousands of people have left positive, encouraging comments. Not all of them, maybe 99% of them. There's a few people who have difference of opinion, which is totally fine, because that's what America's all about. But I wanted to record this video to just share with you kind of why, explain some of the reasons why I said the things I said in that interview. And basically, it's because of what my t-shirt says. You know, my rights don't end where a person's feelings begin. Just because you have a different opinion about the president of the United States, Republicans, Democrats, or anything, just because we don't disagree, just because we don't agree, doesn't mean that you have the right to tell me what I can wear, what I can't wear, how I should think, who I should vote for, or anything. I mean, that's not American at all. And I know you might be saying, well, you know, that's easy for you to say. I've looked at your Facebook profile. You've been very successful in business and financially. You're married to a white woman. You probably live in a white neighborhood. I can understand how you might think that's where I got my current political views from, but that's not true. Most of you know me, you know that's not true, but most of you don't know me. So let me share with you a little bit more about myself and my background so you'll see why I believe the things that I believe. And I was born in East St. Louis, Illinois. Now, if you don't know where East St. Louis is, let's put it this way. It's not like the most thriving urban city in America. Maybe it was at one point, but today it's not. In fact, my parents, they grew up there. They lived on the same street. They got married. They had me. And they left East St. Louis for a better life. My Aunt Juanita, my dad's oldest sister, was one of the first black teachers in the Los Angeles County school system, and she encouraged him to come to California for a better life. My dad was he was one of the first guys back in the 70s who was into computers and things like that. My mom was just looking for a better life. She wanted to get an education. So they moved to California, and when they got there, my dad got caught up in the fast lane and made some decisions and some choices that ended him up in jail, ultimately in prison, for most of my formative years when I was growing up, and even into my adult life today. My mom, on the other hand, she came there to get an education, make a better life for herself. So she moved us into a part of Los Angeles called Baldwin Hills. Back then they called it the jungle. Today they call it South Central Los Angeles. And she worked during the day at a bank, went to school at night to get her education. She ended up getting her degree, got a promotion, which led her to a job transfer to an area of Los Angeles County called the San Gabriel Valley, specifically a city called Temple City. So we moved from South Central Los Angeles to Arcadia, California, which is pretty much a white upper class neighborhood, and which meant I ended up going to pretty much a predominantly white upper class elementary school, middle school, and high school, and beyond. And I got to tell you guys, I didn't experience any racism growing up. That was my experience. I mean, the people that I graduated high school with were basically the same people that I was in elementary school with. So we were all young together. We grew up together. And I mean, maybe somebody had a racist parent or two, but it never transferred to their kids. I mean, I never experienced in Temple City any sort of racism growing through my school years, and which is what led me to register as a Republican. When I turned 18, after starting my first business at 16, earning money on the side, I started a wallpaper hanging business. That's how I bought my first car. I would even take my checks and the money I made for my business and help my mom pay the bills. But when I turned 18 and I had to sign up for this elective service and register to vote, I registered as a Republican. Why? Because I thought at that point in my life, growing up in that time, that the Republican Party was the party that made the most sense to me. It kind of represented what I was thinking about independent people being business owners, lifting themselves up by their bootstraps. That made sense to me. I thought that's the Republican Party. That's the one I want to join. I started met my wife at age 20, started my first business, the business I have today, at age 21, and that's where I began to really understand why I think, because see, I believe that, in fact, and all what I convey to you in this video is that the reason I said the things I said in the interview is that I want to challenge people to believe their experiences and not what the media or the news or even the entertainment people try to tell them about what they should think and who they should vote for or how they should live, because I'm going to challenge you to trust your experiences. Odds are, even if you grew up in South Central Los Angeles or some other, urban part of the country where, you know, it's predominantly black and, you know, maybe lower to middle class. I'm gonna take a stab and say odds are you probably their police officers aren't driving down the street looking to shoot black people just for sport. But that's what the leftist Democrats, the liberals want you to believe. I have friends who are very liberal, and they say they truly believe, and they tell their kids that, you know what, we can't even walk down the street without worrying about getting shot by a police officer, when statistically, the truth is, you're more likely to get shot by a young black male than you are by a police officer. Those are just the facts. People are entitled to their own opinions, but you're not entitled to your own facts. So I challenge people just to focus and believe their experiences. That's what I did. I decided to become a Republican at age 18 because of my experience growing up where I grew up. And I realize it's the same on both sides. Your experience growing up is going to be different, so that may lead you to make some different choices. But focus and believe your experiences rather than what everyone else is telling you to do. In fact, I'm going to challenge you to do not what the crowd is doing, because what I've learned in business and in life, that if you want to be successful, you got to find out what everyone else is doing and do the opposite. And odds are, you're probably going to end up having success. So I started the business I have today at age 21. Today, I have a business in all 50 states, income producing assets and business partners in all 50 states, and even in Canada. And what I learned is that it's all about attitude. In fact, where do we get our attitude from? We get our attitude from our beliefs. Our beliefs come from our experiences, which is really what I'm trying to get across to you. That you people who think the way they think, people say, you know what, white people are the devil. They hate black people. That's an attitude that comes from a belief that comes from your experience. Now, odds are, that's not the experience that most people have had. You've been led to believe by people around you, television, entertainment, that's the truth, and it's not. So I encourage you to really, again, believe what you've experienced in your life and let that set your belief level, which will lead to your attitude, because in my opinion, your attitude is the most important thing in life, because it'll determine what actions you take. And that's what I want to teach my kids, is that your attitude will determine your actions will determine your results, and your results will determine your lifestyle. And your lifestyle will just reinforce what you believe. And then, of course, it's just a big circle. Again, attitude, actions, results, lifestyle. That's the circle of success, in my opinion. So, again, thanks for watching this video. All I wanted to get across to you was to explain to you a little bit more about myself and why I believe the things I believe, and encourage people who look like me, I mean in terms of skin color, that you know what, it's okay to step out from the crowd. I realize that everyone else is going this way, but you don't like that way, but you want to go this way, but everyone else is going that way, so you're going that way too. You can think for yourself. You don't have to follow the crowd. I realize that you're going to get talked about, and people are going to call you names like they call me, Uncle Tom, sellout, Oreo, whatever, it doesn't matter. But you can think for yourself. It's okay. And what we're finding today, more and more people are realizing that. So it's okay to think for yourself and step out from the crowd. So that's really all I wanted to share with you. I look forward to having more conversation with you via video in the future. But again, thanks so much for watching my interview. Thanks so much for watching this video. And I look forward to talking to you again. Bye-bye.